And the topic for tonight's debate is that free-ranged eggs aren't all they're cracked up to be. The affirmative team seated to my right is St. Peter's Girls, and the negative team seated to my left is Glenunga International High School. The speaking time for this debate is 5 minutes. A single warning bell will sound at 1 minute before the speaking time, and a double bell will ring at the speaking time. A continuous bell may be rung 30 seconds after the speaking time, in which case the speaker must sit down immediately. Please ensure that your mobile phones and other electronic devices are switched off. I declare this debate open and call upon the first affirmative speaker, Charlotte Sellers.
Good afternoon, Madam Chairman, ladies and gentlemen. The topic of today's debate is that free-range and organic eggs aren't all they're cracked up to be. We define the topic as that chicken eggs that are free-range, produced by hens which are permitted outside, or organic, produced by hens which are fed organic feed, aren't as superior to other egg farming methods as the government and some farming brands would like us to believe. We, the affirmative team, strongly agree with this statement. Today's first speaker, I'll be talking to you about how these chickens still suffer from similar abuse as caged chickens, as they are both raised on treacherous farms. And then I'll discuss the honesty of the packaging. Our second speaker will be informing you of how free-range eggs are sold at a cheap price in the supermarket and are not genuinely free-range. Also, she'll be talking about the issue of the land use and the free-range egg industry and the dangers of the employees, chickens and buyers' health. Finally, our third speaker will rebut some of our points. I will now be discussing my arguments. My first point is that free-range and organic chickens are treated similar to caged hens. About 13 million eggs are consumed each year in Australia, and the demand is only continuing to grow. About 40% of these eggs are free-range or organic. But what difference does it make to be free-range or organic than to be a regular egg? Shockingly enough, there are very few laws that define these differences. To be free-range, the hen has to be on a farm which obtains the land for them to roam. This land is still extremely crowded, as the law in Australia is that per 1 hectare, there can be 10,000 chickens. That's one hen per square metre. Additionally, there is no mandate on how long the chicken has to be outside for. Some chickens may be outside for as little as 10 minutes per day. Organic laying hens' only difference is that they are not given hormones or in their feed or water during the growing period or while the hen is laying eggs. So free-range chickens still never see their mother, would have been separated from males at birth, and the males would be suffocated in plastic bags or were grinded alive. The hens would have their sensitive beaks cut off by a hot blade without any pain relief. They would suffer from lung lesions. They would have spent majority of their short lives crammed into barns and cages. They would have got breast blisters from sitting in urine and feces-covered floors, been in barns with dead, rotted birds that didn't survive the two-year period of egg laying, and after those 2 years, they'd suffer from the same fate as any other bird would. They'd be shackled upside down, electrocuted, and had their throat slit. And if they weren't already dead, they'd have the peaceful death of being boiled alive. So this truly isn't cracking up to our expectations. My second point is that the labels are very misleading, and lack the vital information for the consumer. As our society advances, people develop morals for animal rights. The government and many farming brands have tried harder and harder to brainwash their potential buyers to purchase their product, their not-so-humane product, ultimately maximising their profit. Unfortunately, they succeeded after the Consumer Affairs Ministers decided to put the interests of large-scale egg producers ahead of the need of the consumer. Now, due to the very high stocking density of free-range eggs, big brands can use the misleading label of free-range that they don't deserve, meaning that brands like Sunny Queen will have the same label as brands like Coles free-range eggs, even though Sunny Queen's hens have fewer chickens per hectare than Coles. Cartons will also not put how long the chicken has been outside for. If a carton says caged, it means the chicken's been inside for 24 hours. But if the carton says free-range, it means the chicken may be inside for 23 hours and 50 minutes. Thus, the measly words free-range and organic lose their meanings and only become labels on a carton. So, Madam Chairman, ladies and gentlemen, in conclusion, if you believe the eggs you buy that are free-range or organic have been produced by chickens which frolic in luscious fields, you're truly living in the wonderland that the government and large-scale farming brands wanted you to dream of. So So that's why free-range and organic eggs are not all they cracked up to be. Thank you. Chairman, ladies and gentlemen. The topic for our debate is that free-range and organic eggs aren't all they're cracked up to be. We, the negative team, believe that this statement is false. We agree with the definitions of... We agree with the definitions of free-range and organic eggs given by the affirmative team. However, we disagree with their definition of cracked up to be. We, the negative team, define cracked up to be as meeting claims and or expectations. As the first speaker, I will be speaking to you about the legal expectations of free-range eggs and organic eggs, and secondly, the information available to the consumer to allow their expectations to be met. Our second speaker will be speaking to you about how consumers have a choice in products and price, how free-range and organic eggs meet the expectations of the Australian egg industry and what the expectations of the Australian egg industry are. Our third speaker will rebut and sum up our team case. I would now like to rebut one of the first affirmative speaker's points. The first affirmative speaker has tried to tell you that chickens still suffer as much as they do in caged egg systems. This is false. There is a continuous support provided by the government and producers to ensure that free-range eggs are meeting the regulations. The first speaker has already outlined the expectations. A stocking density of 10,000 or less is required, and the chickens must be able to roam on the outdoor range. In contrast, according to Animals Australia organisation, the chickens in caged egg systems live their lives in the area size of an iPad. Furthermore, they never see sunlight, and individual care is near impossible. Over the last decade, farmers have made significant investments in infrastructure to improve productivity and animal welfare on their farms. All of this would not have been for the conditions to be the same as caged egg systems. Now to my first point, discussing the legal expectations of free-range and organic egg production and labelling. However, before I begin, I would like to mention that the expectations of free-range and organic eggs come purely from the legislation, which I will outline below, and that any misconceptions are the fault of uneducated consumers, not of free-range and organic eggs. Now to my point. The legal requirements or expectations for free-range eggs are clearly outlined in the Australian Consumer Law Free-Range Egg Labelling Information Standard 2017. Free-range egg standards are defined as Eggs that are laid by hens that have meaningful and regular access to an outdoor range during daylight hours before the laying cycle are able to roam and forage on the outdoor range, have a stocking density of 10,000 hens or less, and the stocking density must also be displayed prominently on the packaging. This legislation has provided consistency between states and territories and sets clear expectations. Many producers choose to exceed these standards and have additional accreditations like RSPCA accredited, Human Choice accredited, or Pasture Fed accredited, all are protected by Australian consumer law. Organic eggs that are exported must be originally certified. This means that the egg producers are not only required to meet the Australian standards for organic and biodynamic products, but exceed them. The Australian standards for organic and biodynamic products for poultry specifically include, but are not limited to, at least one-third of the housing floor must be solid flooring and must include bedding materials, and outdoor stocking rates for layers must now be no more than 1,500 birds per hectare for set stocking or 2,500 for a rotational system. And for meat birds, 2,500 birds per hectare for set stocking and 4,800 for a rotational system and outdoor ranging areas must have an edible foliage available at all times, except for extreme climate conditions. Now my second point is that information is available to the public to make an informed choice so that the eggs can meet their expectations. New legislation requires stocking densities to be prominently displayed on free-range eggs. Industry or association logo certifications are clearly displayed on packaging. Information is available online. There is also a free-range app called Cluck R, which gives information about producers and under what conditions their hens are raised. Information is available to consumers, therefore consumers know what to expect and be able to purchase eggs that meet their expectations. In conclusion, we, the negative team, believe that free-range and organic eggs are indeed all they're cracked up to be, as shown by my previously explained arguments. Thank you.
I call upon the second affirmative speaker, Stella Clark.
Good afternoon, Madam Chairman, ladies and gentlemen. The topic for our debate is that organic and free-range eggs aren't all they're cracked up to be. We, the affirmative team, believe that this statement is true and the public don't need to scramble over these organic and free-range eggs. Our first speaker has already informed you of the similarities between the conditions of free-range birds and caged birds and how producers abuse the term free-range and as a result mislead the buyer. Today, as second speaker, I will argue that organic and free-range eggs do not have a positive impact on the economy or the environment and therefore aren't all they're cracked up to be. Before I begin my debate, I would like to point out some flaws in the first negative speaker's argument. The first negative speaker stated that the government makes sure that the conditions of free-range birds are constantly being met. Then why was one of the largest egg producers in Australia just recently fined over falsely advertising their produce as free range, and another producer fined over $1 million for the same thing. The first negative speaker has tried to tell you that our first speaker has said that the caged hens are treated the same, but she said similar, and she used evidence from PETA and RSPCA, so therefore we can discount her rebuttal. Now I'm going to discuss my first point, that organic and free-range eggs are not all they're cracked up to be, because they do not positively affect the economy. First of all, the cage industry only earns $10 per 219 chickens, and cage-free chickens require much more space, and organic chickens require expensive organic feed that's grown without the harsh chemicals and without pesticides. It costs $1.07 to produce a dozen caged eggs, $1.33 to produce a dozen barn eggs, and $1.59 to produce a dozen free-range eggs. This results in the free-range industry earning very little amounts of money. So if you see a dozen free-range eggs in the supermarket for only $4 or $3, it is highly likely that they're not free-range. Humane Society International Director Verna Simpson states that at this price, the producer would just go broke. This is proof that free-range eggs aren't genuinely free-range, and therefore the industry is not all it's cracked up to be. What people don't know about free-range eggs is the impact that the system can have on the environment. Take land use, for example. To get 10 dozen eggs, you would need roughly 35 or 48 square metres of land, and therefore the industry isn't all it's cracked up to be. Another major concern is the workers' conditions in the free-range industry. Cage-free birds tend to build up piles of manure, which causes large amounts of dust particles, which contain pathogens and toxins that the employees and the chickens then inhale. This is a major issue that poses a risk to people working in these free-range systems, and therefore the industry is not all it's cracked up to be. Another issue regarding the piles of manure is that the chickens have a natural drive to search through the manure, hoping to find worms and other insects. This is a big problem because the chickens are in contact with their own manure and are likely to get salmonella. And if one chicken gets salmonella, all the other chickens get sick too. In a caged industry, the eggs never even come into contact with manure. So why is everybody scrambling over the cage-free industry? So, Madam Chairman, ladies and gentlemen, in conclusion, we, the Affirmative Team, strongly believe that organic and free-range eggs aren't all they're cracked up to be. This is because these eggs have a negative impact on the economy and the environment, where customers are not buying genuinely free-range eggs when they spend only $4. In addition to this, free-range industries mean that the workers and the chickens are in contact with particles that contain deadly toxins and pathogens. This can result in one chicken getting salmonella and then all the other chickens getting salmonella. So when customers are buying free-range eggs, they are actually buying eggs that have come into contact with manure. This, ladies and gentlemen, is why organic and free-range eggs aren't all they're cracked up to be. Thank you.
Thank you.
free-range and organic eggs are not all they're cracked up to be. We, the negative team, strongly believe that this statement is false. Our first speaker has already spoken to you about the legal expectations and the information that is available to the consumers. I will be discussing how free-range and organic eggs offer choice to the consumer and the benefits this puts on the egg industry. However, first, I will address some of the flaws and problems with the affirmative team's argument. The second speaker has said that free-range chickens cause environmental issues because they use a lot of land. Well, as the affirmative team have pointed out, caged eggs have very, very cruel, inhumane conditions. So that being said, is it worth having free-range chickens roaming around? Is it worth having chickens inhumanely and cruelly suffering just to save land? I think not. The first speaker has also said that producers are passing off free-range eggs, which are very similar to cage eggs, and this is misleading. In any industry, there are always cases where breaches occur. There are systems in place to deal with these companies. If they are misleading, then they can and will be prosecuted by the ACCC, as mentioned by our first speaker. For example, Stockdale Property Limited in Western Australia will fine over $1 million. Penalties are very harsh. This is not the fault of the egg, but the individual company. My first point is that free-range and organic eggs offer choice. The fact is that the eggs are not all the same. They vary in stocking densities, environmental conditions, and farming practices. Some only meet the minimum standards, and other eggs come from free-range hens, where their production practice exceeds the standard set by legislation. For an example of one of these companies is Fryer's Kangaroo Island Eggs. Some people also argue that the eggs should all be the same, or that there should be higher standards of the legislation. The reality is that because all eggs are different, people get choices. Usually, but not always, these choices are determined by price. Having a variety of choices, starting from the Woolworths free-range eggs, which meet the minimum standard, is a more ethical choice than having barn-laid or caged eggs. If you can afford or want a more environmentally or nutritionally superior egg, they are certainly on the supermarket shelf. They can have lower stocking densities, certifications from companies such as the RSPCA, Human Choice Society, FRIPA, and Proof. However, they usually come at a different price. For example, Woolworths free range retail at $4.40, and Fryer's Kangaroo Island eggs with the Humane Choice certification cost $7.10. But whatever your priorities or budget, there are free range and organic eggs to meet everyone's expectations. Some special interest groups like RSPCA argue that the standards should be higher than the current legislation. As standards go up, so do the production costs, and this is ultimately passed on to the consumer. Many producers would be unwilling or unable to meet the additional standards. Some producers would have no alternative but to go back to cage or barn-laid eggs. Therefore, higher production costs and less competition would potentially increase the price of eggs. So where is the RSPCA when you're standing at the checkout paying $10 for free-range eggs? Nowhere to be seen, I'm sure. According to the Quantum Market Research, who surveyed 1,200 free-range egg consumers throughout Australia, 76% would not buy free-range eggs if they were over $5.50. What good is a premium product that only a few people can afford? It's not. Currently, free-range eggs offer a range of prices, therefore meeting consumers' expectations. My second point is the industry benefits. The consumer demand for free-range eggs has sent its market share jump from being 20% 10 years ago to 40% now, with organic eggs having 1% of the market today. A report by IBIS World on egg farming in Australia reported that the egg industry is growing almost 5% per year and have attributed this partially to the shift from caged to free-range eggs. So, Madam Chairman, ladies and gentlemen. In conclusion, we believe that organic and free-range eggs not only provide the choice to meet consumer expectations, but also industry expectations. Therefore, the statement that free-range and organic eggs are not all they're cracked up to be is false. Thank you.
Good evening, ladies, gentlemen, Madam Chairperson and Adjudicator. Tonight I'm arguing that free-range and organic eggs are not all they're cracked up to be. Tonight I will summarise my team's case, but not before I point out some flaws in the opposition's argument. The negative team believes that the expectations for which free-range and organic eggs must meet are set by the legislation and laws, not by the consumers. But we disagree, as the topic is not confined to just laws, and every expectation should be taken into account. Also, the laws around this matter are confusing and differ across the country. The first negative has claimed that the government provides continuous support to monitor the treatment of chickens. They didn't say what this support entails or what happens in other countries. The negative team argues that free-range and organic farmers are following the laws and regulations. But there are so many different standards in Australia and no single national definition of free-range eggs. This means that the system isn't as strict and defined as it should be. Farmers are getting away with following many standards that are irresponsible and humane. According to Kelly O'Dwyer, an honourable politician, there is no single national definition for free-range or organic. The first speaker also discussed that there are improvements in the legislation, allowing consumers to have more of an idea of what they are getting when they buy their eggs. But this is the fallacy of appeals to the fallacy of a red herring, as it is not related to the topic. They are only pointing out improvements, not whether the eggs are meeting the expectations. The second negative has argued that there are free-range and organic eggs to meet everyone's expectations. But we disagree, as the labels on these eggs can be misleading and deceiving, and it is hard to tell if you are really getting what you want. The negative team's first speaker told you that there were many people uphold the laws placed on free-range and organic eggs. Yet, their second speaker gave examples of people breaking their laws or those who couldn't reach the same standards, such as the Woolworths example. Therefore, they discounted their own argument. The, ne- negative speaker has stated that it was not the egg's fault that caused the Australian egg company to lose over $1 million, but it was the company's fault instead. Yet it does not matter whether or not this is true, because it doesn't change the fact that the company was fined and was abusing the term free range, meaning that free range eggs are simply not all they cracked up to be. The second speaker told us that the price of land is less than the price of the chicken's happiness. Well, chickens do not in fact enjoy the wide open plains of land that they get to roam. And in a study in the UK of over 800,000 chickens, only 15% of the total flock were ever found outside at one time, because they enjoy areas with trees that are more confined and safe. Now I shall conclude my team's case. Our first speaker has explained that free range and organic does not directly translate to the happy chickens on our egg cartons. She pointed out the other cruelties a chicken must suffer, apart from being trapped indoors, and she discussed how the laws and labels surrounding this issue are unclear and dotted with many loopholes. This was followed by our second speaker, who argued the environmental side of this debate, including the effects of manure and land usage. She also raised an economic factor and how cheap free-range eggs are simply impossible. So ladies and gentlemen, the difference between free-range, organic and regular eggs is negligible, and in the end all eggs crack up to be the same, some whites and a yolk. So as much as we try, no chicken's life can be turned sunny side up, and the only solution is to change our eating habits. In conclusion, free-range, organic are simply loose terms used more of a marketing technique than a way to improve our chickens and eggs. Thank you.
On the third negative speaker, Sherry Wong.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, Madam Chairperson. The topic for our debate today is that free-range and organic eggs aren't all they're cracked up to be. We, the negative team, strongly believe that this statement is false. Now to the rebuttal. One point that I must stress very strongly that the third speaker has stated numerous times is that there is no single law about the labels for free-range eggs. Now this statement is entirely false. Throughout our team case, we have already we have already referred to the Australian Consumer Law Free Range Egg Labelling Information Standard 2017, the most recent one. I will continue to refer to this throughout my speech tonight. The first speaker has mentioned that the legislation will make no difference because it is 10,000 hens per hectare. The Australian Consumers Law states that this is the maximum number of chickens per hectare. As our second speaker has stated, in the market there is choice. Some producers decide to meet them and others decide to exceed them. An example is the Friars Kangaroo Island eggs who farm eggs where farm chickens farm 1,500 chickens per hectare. It is the consumer's choice whether or not they want to buy the ones that exceed the expectations or the ones that meet their expectations. The first, second, and third affirmative speakers have also said that producers take advantage of the free-range egg label. Now, one of the reasons of this is because prior to 2017, there was no national regulation across the states. Now, there was no consistency. However, now there is. Our first speaker has explained the Australian Consumer Law Information Standard 2017 and how there must be numerous regulations and also regulations that are very strict that producers must meet if they are to label their eggs as free range. The second speaker has stated that there are many health problems with free range production. Now, farmers do agree that there are positives and negatives to the free-range egg production industry. This is likewise for the caged egg industry. However, at the end of the day, free-range egg production is supporting animal welfare, and we are trying to steer away from the cruelties of caged egg industry. This is what is important is that this expectation is met, as it is what free-range eggs are for. The second speaker has also stated that they do not benefit the economy. Free-range eggs and organic eggs have higher costs, but they are worth investing in. According to the Australian Consumer Law, again, eggs labelled as free-range sell at a higher price because these production systems can be more expensive to manage and operate, and more investments are needed to ensure that animal welfare regulations are met. She's also said that the free-range egg industry is earning very little money. However, this is false. An increasing number of consumers are prepared to pay more for eggs that have been laid by freely ranging hens. And in response, the proportion of eggs labelled as free-range has increased substantially. As our second speaker has already stated, Australian Egg Corporation Annual Report 2016 shows caged egg sales are down to 49.5% of the market. 10 years ago, it was 74.9%. Free-range eggs are on the rise and consumers are happy to pay for them. To sum up our team's case, our first speaker has already spoken to you about the legal expectations of free-range eggs and organic eggs. She has also provided information about how the consumer has access to information to allow their personal expectations to be met. Our second speaker has spoken to you about how free-range eggs and organic eggs offer choice to the consumer. She's also explained how they are beneficial to the Australian egg industry. In conclusion, ladies and gentlemen, consumers have a wide choice in terms of which eggs they want to purchase to meet their personal expectations. The Australian Consumer Law and the Certified Organic Scheme that we have not mentioned much today, but for organic eggs, recognise the need to provide certainty for customers and to clearly state what their free-range eggs and organic eggs really are. There is no way that the consumer can't purchase eggs that don't meet their own expectations. That is why free-range